All right, now on to another maddening story we're following tonight. New Jersey Attorney General Gurbir Grewal just issued a new rule that will handcuff cops from arresting illegal immigrants. The new guidelines saying that New Jersey police cannot stop or detain anyone based on their immigration status. They can't ask the immigration status of anyone unless it's part of an ongoing investigation. And officers will not be able to cooperate or participate in ICE raids. This basically classifies New Jersey as a sanctuary state. Joining me now is Kim Guadagno. She's a former lieutenant governor of New Jersey. Kim, you've actually been warning of this for a long time. We had that horrific case. And I'm just going to remind everyone, put the photo up. This is Luis Rodrigo Perez, 23-year-old Mexican national, accused of killing three people in Missouri after being released in New Jersey on domestic violence charges and other crimes as well. He was released. ICE wasn't notified, went on to kill three people. Now this, Kim.
Well, it's more than that. Middlesex County, which is where he was in jail, decided not to honor any legitimate federal detainers. So they let him out. They simply ignored the fact that he should have been turned over to the federal authorities and let him out. And as a result, a couple weeks later, he's in Missouri killing three people. Now, it's not the first time it's happened in New Jersey. There was an incident when I got involved, when I was the sheriff in 2007, where another illegal immigrant was taken into custody. He had committed a crime in New Jersey. He was released out on bail, even though there was a federal retainer in 2007, went into a playground and shot three college kids in the head with a gun, and is now spending 155 years in prison. Yet our attorney general here in New Jersey thinks that immigrants need more protection than they already
get. Well, Kim, 500,000, a little more than that now, illegal immigrants living in the state of New Jersey, among the highest populations, in certainly on the East Coast, not more than California or Texas, right, but still a significant number of people. And the police are sitting, you know, they're just trying to deal with this.
Well,
but the liberal politicians say, oh, it's going to help law enforcement work with the immigrant community.
Right.
Do you buy that?
Create trust. They call the immigrant trust doctrine. Look, this isn't a question of immigration. This is a question of public safety. And what we know, and when you look at the doctrine itself, you know, on its face, it sounds really good. Immigrant trust. Let's make sure that everybody is free to report crimes. But what really happens when you get into the details is law enforcement on the local level is no longer allowed to cooperate with federal law enforcement. So that puts federal officers at risk. They go to a sweep in an area, a lawful sweep, one that's sanctioned by a court, one that's sanctioned by government, yet they're not allowed to confer at all with local law enforcement. That puts those poor federal immigration officers at risk. It also, quite frankly, puts the public at risk. When you put a wedge between federal government and the state government, we know exactly what happens.
Well,
we
listen to this. Tonight, we just found out that ICE has announced that it's probably going to be stepping up raids in New Jersey.
Well, they have to.
Because of this new policy. ICE spokesman Emilio Dabul said in an email, the probability that large arrests and worksite enforcement ops, which already exists, will likely increase due to the fact that ICE will no longer have the cooperation of the jails related to immigration enforcement. It's going to happen.
So, look, I brought immigration into my jail when I was the sheriff because I thought the public understood that it was already there, that we wouldn't release dangerous people into the community without running their full background. Now, this doctrine is so petty.
Yeah.
This doctrine is so petty that the federal government can't even use desks in the jails.
Right. Kim, thank you so much for your insights on this. We're going to be tracking this. New Jersey, it's a shame. Shame on you.